Hey, so you all know I'm Mike. I'm an RA here in Panther Hall, and I'm about to tell you why you should go on a date with me. So let me start by saying I love puppies so much, and this is going for a great cause, the Western Humane Society. Because I love puppies so much, I decided to take advice that my grandmother always used to give me. She always used to say, "Absence makes the heart grow fonder." And as you all know, I'm absent, which means you're now all fonder of me, and hopefully we can make some money and go on a great date because I'm very eligible and I'm about to tell you why I'm worth spending money on and going on a date. So your lovely RSA came up with these questions for me, and I'm gonna answer them and we could get to know each other a little better. So, number one, describe your perfect date. So, RSA, I need some clarification here. Are we talking date as in person or date as an activity? I'll give you both because I'm a giving person. So, my perfect date as a person is someone who's independent, opinionated, adventurous, likes to smile, and ultimately cares about people and is willing to listen and also share some of their details about her life with me. In terms of what I like to do, my ideal date would be something adventurous, skydiving, mountain climbing, surfing, anything like that. I mean, I would have a great time doing, but those are all like, maybe not as realistic all the time. So I love to go bowling. I get a little bit competitive, but I always have a good time. It's the perfect combination of like social, but also like you're doing enough stuff, so it breaks the ice a little bit. Question number two, an interesting fact about myself. So I'm a twin, actually. I'm a fraternal twin. I'm the much taller twin, so if that's relevant to your dating preferences, you're in the right place. But I love him to death, and hopefully he'll be around sometime. You can meet him, but I think the consensus is that I'm the superior twin. At least that's what I've been telling people since I've been in third grade. So three words to describe yourself. I would go with intelligent, compassionate. And third one, that's tough. I'll go with sincere. I think intelligent, compassionate, and sincere, I think are three words that I think describe me pretty well. So number four, best personal quality. Similar to number three, RSA. Give me some variety here, but my best personal quality, I think I like to think I genuinely care about people and maybe you can disagree with that, but I think I'd like to genuinely, well, I can't even talk. I'm nervous. This is a big day. I can genuinely care about people, and I'm very proud of that, I think. Five, my favorite show. So I don't watch much TV, but my favorite show is Survivor. I love it. I love the strategy. I love the thought of being on a deserted island, tropical location. I think it's awesome. And it's also the physical element. There's a huge strategic element. There's a physical element. I think it's important to push your limits and, to see what you can do and what you're capable of and really realize your potential. And I think Survivor brings all that together. So, my favorite weekend activity, number six. Well, if you go on a date with me, you could possibly shoot my Survivor casting tape video as our activity, but my favorite activity in the weekend, I like to sleep. That's not fun, but I like to run a lot. I usually go on long runs on the weekend. I'm training for my second marathon. So that's something I like to do. I like to read. That's also super fun activity for multiple people to do together. But yeah, I mean, I like to keep things low key and not too exciting on the weekend. Safety first. So finally, number seven, one thing on my bucket list. So I feel pretty strongly that bucket lists should be ambitious. So one thing that's on my bucket list is I would like to see Earth from outer space. And because I intend to live a long time and hopefully be kind of wealthy, space tourism is definitely going to be a thing in my lifetime. So I think I'd definitely like to get up there either as an engineer or at least as a tourist. But something that's a little more likely to happen in the near term is one of my bucket list goals is to qualify and run the Boston Marathon because it's, the biggest marathon in America. It's got a great history. My uncle's done it before. I really look up to him. So that's something that's on my bucket list. And that's all the questions that your RSA had for me. So I think we should step back and let the bidding begin. Here we go.